Good morning, people. It's race weekend at Circuit de Catalunya in Barcelona. And we're heading out to the track. And guess who's driving? It's me.
No, of course not.
There he is.
Hello.
Hi.
Well, riding with Marcus in a car, navigating. It's a bit like riding with Kimmy in,
So far it's good, I think.
Yeah?
We're not lost yet. So.
We're not lost yet, no. Not
you're
like
the co-driver, so I trust your, you know the way.
Yeah, that's the first error, yeah. Anyway, it's Thursday.
Ah.
That's the woman who's trying to direct us. She knows nothing. So, Thursday, and Circuit de Catalunya, could you say something about the track? It's one of your favorite tracks, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a track I've been to a lot of times, many laps I've done over the years. It's quite a good track. You have a good mix of everything, quick corners, slow corners, some quick combinations, so... Yeah, it's a track I like, and I've been there, finished on the podium there, and been quick, so it's pretty good.
Yeah? Could you talk us around one lap of the track? You are on the start-finish line, on the rev limiter, heading for turn one. Now what?
Yeah, coming into turn one and two, which is a bit of a quick chicane, and... it's a bit of a quick chicane. It's a hard break, but it's quite a difficult one for turn one, as it's a long straight before it, so it's quite easy to get some front tires lockups and stuff like that, so you need to be a bit careful. After turn one, two, you have the quick turn three, which is a very long corner where you need to carry a lot of speed. Ska vi mot AP eller CC?
Oh, left.
Okay.
Right. This is great.
quick and long turn three, which is just a small lift. You're coming into turn four, which is also a long corner where you can carry quite a bit of speed. It's quite difficult in the exit because it's quite oversteery generally.
And then it goes going downhill again.
Then you go downhill to turn five, which is a quite bumpy entry, but it's quite a slow basic corner. You go on a straight and get to turn 7-8, which is you could say a bit of a quick chicane. You can carry quite a bit of speed through. You use a lot of curb in the exit. After that, you get up to turn 9. This is good practice. You
yeah, think talking and thinking yeah. And driving, yeah?
So you get up to turn 9, I think it is. It's a quick right-hander, which is also no brakes, just a lift. You need to carry a lot of speed, be a bit brave. Then you get to the back straight, coming down to the hairpin. What a... normal hairpin kind of corner, you brake hard and late and then you get the pink turn and on the throttle. Then you're into the last sector. Starts with a bit of a long right-hander, I don't know the exact corner number of that corner. And then you come into the last tricky part where it's a third gear right-hander going into a really slow and tight chicane. This is a place where you can lose a lot of time on a qualifying lap, for example, because it's very technical and it's very easy to overdrive and you know, want, if you want a bit too much, you can overdrive and brake a bit late and then you can lose a lot of lap time. So for me, the last sector is a real tricky one and you need to be a bit patient and precise not to make any mistakes and lose a lot of time. But then you're out on the last corner is a kink, but that's flat with new tires, and then you're out on the start finish straight again.
Yeah. So best overtaking points. Turn one on the inside, preferably.
Turn one is quite good. And we're going off here.
No,
we
are. Straight.
Yeah, straight ahead.
According to the lady in the front.
Yeah. Turn one is good. Turn five on the inside is pretty good.
Turn five, that's after the downhill.
No, the downhill corner.
Yeah.
And then what else? Yeah, down to the hairpin on the back. The back straight down to the hairpin is also quite good. So that would be the best places for overtaking.
Yeah. This must be the most confusing interview we've ever done.
It's a bit tricky, but yeah, it's good practice, and so far we're doing well, so yeah, I'm quite happy.
Just short, it's Thursday. What happens else on a Thursday, on a race weekend?
Now when we get to the track, I will do the weigh-in, and then we do a track walk. After that, we have some briefings with the team to go through the plan for the weekend, and then we have the driver's briefing at 5 o'clock this afternoon. And that's pretty much it.
Yeah, that sounds great. So all set up for a perfect weekend then.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, we'll bring you more interviews, and perhaps we will not do them in the car next time. Okay. Thanks. Best of luck.